Hi everyone, good evening. We are here today with my very, very dear friend Menaz Khan. She is one of the best cat people I know in the grooming industry. Menaz is a certified international certified cat groomer, and she runs a cat boarding and grooming salon called Catsperts. She is based in Bangalore, so you know, all of you guys who are in Bangalore, I suggest you look her up because she is one of the best I know. And she's also part of the PPGAI. So yeah, that's like an added bonus. So hi, Menaz. Thank you for joining
Thank
us today.
Thank you so much, Andrea, for the introduction.
Okay, so if you could, just tell us a little bit about yourself, and then we'll move on to, what this whole session is about.
So basically, I'm an international certified cat groomer, as you said. And then I'm kind of into animal communication also, and into I groom both cats as well as dog, but much more specialized into cats. And I'm doing this since more than 6 years. And right. So the session, we are just going to talk about more about cat grooming, how to maintain your cats at home, like just a basic combing, eye cleaning, ear cleaning, nail clipping, and more about the myths and everything.
Right. Yeah. Okay. So Menaz, now let's just start with I think we should start with busting some myths. If you're okay with that. So sure. Let's. Can we start with some myths that people have regarding cats and cat grooming, and why it's important and things like that. So could you just give us a little?
So basically, it's a myth wherein people have that kind of mentality wherein cats groom themselves. So cats don't groom themselves, they lick themselves. Okay.
Right.
So while licking themselves, what they are doing is they are just they are just spreading the saliva all over their body, which is not really helping them. So what they do is because of that saliva, the dander and everything, people say, oh, I'm allergic to cats. So they are not allergic to the cat. So they are allergic to the dander, which is created by the saliva when they lick themselves. Okay.
So I was going to ask you. So when people say my cat doesn't need to have a bath, is that correct or is that wrong?
All cats need grooming. It's not that my cat don't require a bath. Though it is a long hair cat or a short hair cat. If they are domesticated, if they are indoor cats, yes, they have to go ahead. We have to go ahead and give them bath. If they are outdoor indoor cat, the problem is outdoor cat, normally they go outside, they dust themselves, and also they really don't require so much of grooming. If you see our feral cats, you see them, they are very clean, neat and clean, because they take care of themselves. The nature, normally it helps them to take care of themselves. But when you see if we have totally indoor cats, they don't have mud or something to dust themselves or degrease themselves, nothing as such. So yeah, they are totally dependent on us.
Okay. So would you say that it is okay for us to shave a cat because the person in the house is allergic to the cat, or is there something else that somebody should be doing instead of shaving their cat to ward off allergies?
So shaving the cat is not really a good option because their follicle is very much smaller. So while shaving, what we are doing is we are vegetating with the follicle and everything. So you will see after the hair grows and everything, you will see more of the hair fall later on. Okay.
Okay.
So that is not really a good part. What they can do is instead they can just regularly bathe their cat, or they can trim their cat at least 1 inch or something, so that they are not going through the follicle, they are not touching the follicle.
Right. So basically, you should not be exposing the skin.
If you shave, there's more chances of skin infection. This, that is too much. Because the skin is more exposed to the surface.
Okay. And in my experience, Menaz, and when you used to be with me as well, we've seen cats coming in, where people have tried to cut out their knots or mats, and they've actually cut the skin. So can you advise people on what should be done and how you would, prevent something like that?
So
especially in the armpit area. Right?
Yeah. So if you want, what you can do is you can keep the armpit area, because normally I have seen people, what they do is they don't hold the cat properly while brushing them or while combing them. Okay, right. So that's the reason the mat has been created, and the cats are not used to of like, you know, combing and brushing. So that's the reason the mat has been created over there. So you have to make sure that you start brushing combing at a very early age. And apart from that, the second part is don't really go ahead and cut the knot. You take a help of a professional. Go ahead. If you can't like, you know, afford a grooming or something like that, just go to remove the knots at least, like, instead of cutting
with a brush or a comb or something.
The reason if you cut, cat skin is much more thinner than our skin, and like, you know, and you might end up cutting the skin of the cat.
Right. Okay. So yeah, I mean, we have seen, like I have seen in my experience, you know, a lot of cats that come to us where the owners have tried to cut out the knots and, you know, injured the cat pretty badly.
And do you think not trust us?
Exactly. So that's what I was going to ask you next. Like, you know, do you feel that it has an effect on their the future of their grooming with a profession or with somebody at home? They do develop that fear, right? Because they've been injured once, so they obviously are not going to be trusting of anybody else.
They don't trust. And even like, you know, when they see any kind of like, you know, brush, comb or something like that, they'll just freak out and they'll try to run.
Right. Okay. Because they are associating this with, you know, with this kind of
bad experience. Yeah.
Okay. Cool. So Manaz, like our session is today, it's about the four steps to groom your cat at home. Okay. Can you give us a little brief introduction on what all you're going to cover, and then we'll go into each topic one at a time. Okay. So could you just give us a brief thing of what we're going to be doing?
So we will be showing you how to really maintain your cat's eyes like regularly. Cleaning the ears, which right tool you have to use to comb your long hair cat and a short hair cat, and at home how you can do the nail clipping.
Okay, cool, great. So maybe we can start, you know, with a little of what these tools look like and what are the kind of tools that a cat owner should have with them so as to take care of their cat, you know, and groom their cat at home. So if you could just give us a few tools, and also could you introduce this beautiful little white kitty in front of you to us?
His name is Smurf. He's my 8-year-old cat.
Hi, Smurf. And,
and he is not a Persian, by the way. People say they are Persian cats. All long hair cats are not Persian cats. So he's a traditional long hair cat according to World Cat Federation and according to CFA, that is Cat Fanciers Association. He is a domestic long hair cat.
Okay, so that is news to, you know, I'm sure a lot of us, that all long-haired cats are not Persian cats.
Persian cats,
so,
yes.
Cool.
And each cat, like, you know, if you see Persian, they require different grooming. If you see a long-haired cat, they have a droppy coat. They require different kind of grooming. So, yeah.
Right, okay.
Ask a professional.
So you would recommend that before somebody gets a kitten home, regardless of the breed, whether it's an Indian or a Persian or a, you know, exotic short hair or whatever breed it is, they should do a little bit of homework before they get this kitten home.
Okay, yes, cool. Yes, definitely, yes. So this is the tool, which is one is the steel comb, which is available on Amazon or like, you know, websites, wherever, like, you know, it is of Andes company.
Okay.
And this is a face comb, which is not easily available. What you can do is you can use a flea comb instead. Like, you know, this is basically for the face area, for the chin area and everything. Okay. And then this is a slicker brush. It should be soft enough, not hard at all. You can just touch and see. It shouldn't hurt your cat. Okay. So there are slicker brush which comes normally. They say slicker brush, but some slicker brushes are there to remove the knots and all and to be used on the dogs. So cat should be like a little bit softer if you see. Okay. And then the nail clipper. And for the short hair cat, a Furminator.
Okay. What does the Furminator do?
Furminator, it removes all the dead hair.
Okay.
Okay. From the coat, basically. And it can be used for both long hair and short hair, but not regularly.
Okay.
It might hurt the skin also.
Okay, so how often would you say we should be using a Furminator at home?
Once in like 5 days or once a week, not regularly.
Okay, really, and this is for all cats, for long as well as short hair cats.
So there are different Furminator. One is for the short coat also you get, and one is for the long coat you get. So you have to see the fact, okay, you're taking it for the long coat or you're taking it for the short coat.
Okay, and is this Furminator easily available in the market?
Yes, very much easily available.
Okay, awesome, cool.
And with the company name only directly Furminator, so you can just search
okay.
about.
Right, okay, cool. So now, so we have a few people that have joined us. Let's just say hello quickly. We have, hi Saloni, hi Nishad. Hi Purnima, hi Batul. Oh, Batul is actually Minaz's really cool sister, who is also a really
she's
awesome cat.
Yeah, she's a cat behaviorist.
Okay, she's a cat behaviorist. Wow, so this sister duo is actually the go-to people for your cat. So in case you guys have any questions about cats, they have a page on Instagram and Facebook called Catsperts. So it's CATSPERTS. So you guys can follow them and ask them questions there as well. And they are always happy to help and, you know, give you, you know, tips and tricks on how to take care of your little kitties at home. So having said that, now, hi, I'm going to say to the rest of the people. Hi, Sandeep. Hi, Yefna. Yefna is also Menaz's friend, right, Yefna? Hi, Batul again. Okay, we have, hi, Sandeep, Zaheer. Hi, Alexander, Atchis, and okay. So Saloni has a question for us. So yeah. I'm going to put that up for us. She's asking us, is there a huge difference when it comes to grooming a short-haired cat and a long-haired cat in terms of time and effort?
Okay. So I would say, Saloni, short-haired cat and long-haired cat, okay? So if you see, people tend to get, like, you know, short-haired cat, but let me be, like, you know, frank, short-haired cat sheds a lot as compared to the long hair cats. Okay, right. So there are a lot of differences wherein you have to maintain both the cats, like, you know, yeah, in terms of shampoos and all that thing, drying and, like, you know, you say combing, yeah, there is a difference in terms of combing, but bath and okay. everything is almost similar.
Okay, right, okay. So now if you could just show us a little demo on how you would brush your long hair cat, since you have Smurf in front of you and Smurf is waiting to, you know, be a little model for us. We'd love to see, you know, how we should be brushing our kitties at home.
Okay, so just take a comb. Start with, like, you know, they love this area to be combed first, okay? So
okay, you mean underneath area, the neck and the chin?
Yeah, so whichever area okay. you like, okay, go ahead and, like, you know, comb it out first. And you have to comb it outward, okay? Like, you can see
okay.
this way.
Right.
There are no knots. It's not getting stuck anywhere.
Okay.
So go ahead with the upper
So
part.
What would you say are the friction areas for, you know, your cat? Where do we normally have to concentrate on so that, you know, they're
under
not getting
the,
knots in those yeah. areas?
So it's basically near the armpit, near the bum area especially. Okay. And under the thigh, that area are the most has a friction.
Okay, so they're yeah. most prone to getting knots and like mats yeah. and stuff like that, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. And what about how do we use, like, a slicker brush on you know, on your cat? Because now a slicker brush has pointy pins, right? So how would you use it in a safe and effective manner, not hurting your cat and getting your knots and mats out?
Okay, so basically hold the slicker brush like this. One second. Mm-hmm. Anna. 1 minute. Yeah. Okay. So hold the slicker brush like this. Sorry. Okay. And comb it out.
Okay. So basically, you just need to keep your.
Yeah. Slicker brush you don't have to use on a long hair cat. Only when drying, just to separate the like, you know, coat, we just use a slicker brush. Okay.
Okay. So basically, very gently, not we don't
yeah,
press
very
it.
Gently. Yeah. Just, like, you know, just kind of removing, like, kind of just whatever the unwanted hair is up above body. That's it.
Okay. Yeah. Cool. We have a question from Sandeep. He's saying, "Do cats like grooming? I mean, is their nature supportive while you groom them?"
Yes, they do like grooming. All cats, like, they love water. It's us, like, you know, normally we think, oh, my cat doesn't like water or something like that. I've seen a lot of people while grooming the cat also, it's like kind of a mission for them. They will be like, oh, now their mind is prepared, okay? Now I'll be getting scratches, now I'll be getting, like, you know, bite and all that stuff. But yeah, they really like it if you do it in a proper way. If you go ahead with, like, you know, introducing them at a very early age.
Okay, so how early would you say is it okay to bathe your kitten?
So after first vaccination, mostly like around 2 months or something, you can start bathing your cat. But the mild shampoo is a yellow shampoo.
Okay, and also that when you know, I have seen a lot of people use any random shampoos on cats, and I have actually seen cats react badly. So what would you say to that?
Use a pet like I would say use a shampoo which is designed only for like, you know, dogs and cats. Don't use the shampoo which is like, you know, out of like, you know, our human shampoo. I've seen a lot of people using our human shampoo on them. It's very harsh for them. We shouldn't use that. And then okay. I have seen a lot of people, they use chicken flea shampoo also on cats, like, you know. So you should understand cats live themselves, and the toxicity rate will be really very much high on cats if the shampoo stays on the body. So we shouldn't use chicken flea shampoo on cats, not even the powders also.
So what about if you're, you know, if you say you've rescued a kitten from the street and the kitten is full of fleas? So what do you do in that case? So do you not use a tick and flea shampoo? Can or no. Do you what think do using is, a normal shampoo will help?
Yeah. So what we do is we use that tick and flea powder a little bit. We just sprinkle, but that too you have to take a professional's help. You can't do it like, you know, at home, because like, you know, they might get pneumonia and they might get heart attack, any kind of problem they might get. So you have to take.
You mean that the cat can actually get a heart attack with the toxicity to the you know, to a ticket.
Not about the toxicity also, like, you know, they will freak out and suddenly, like, you know, when they are kitten, they might, like, you know, end up like that. So it's not really a good idea, right? So you have to be very much calm and, like, you know, start with the grooming session. You have to sprinkle a little bit of tick and flea powder, which is like, you know, a natural one, not like, you know, which has high kind of chemicals in that. And then bathe immediately after like 5 minutes or something. Don't let them bathe.
Okay, cool. All right, cool. So Batul is asking the best kind of comb to remove knots on your cat.
You go ahead with this kind of comb only. It really helps in removing the knots. Or if it is mat or something, then try to trim it off.
Okay, so what if you don't have a trimmer at home? And, you know, there is a really big fat mat maybe next to the ear or in the armpit or, you know, behind the thigh, the friction areas that you were talking about earlier. Then what do you recommend?
Go to a groomer,
a professional groomer who is... Okay.
Yeah, you don't want to hurt your cat. Why do you want to hurt your cat?
Right, true. Okay, cool. So, somebody's asking, can you tell me that the hair grows based on the quality of food? Shahid is asking, can you tell me that the hair grows based on the quality of food? See, what he's trying to ask is that
nutrition plays an important role. Basically, it's not only like, you know, grooming. Nutrition plays an important role in the hair growth and everything as well.
Okay, cool. So, Nishad has asked, can you share the grooming accessories names and details? I mean, the brands and availability. So can you just quickly run us through all of the grooming tools that you were showing us?
Okay. So this is like Andes company comb, steel comb. Okay. Second thing is you get a flea comb just to use near the face area. Okay. So this kind of a small comb you have to go ahead with. Then you can... Okay, the ear cleaner, you can go with any kind of ear cleaner, or best is the ear wipe. If you're at home, use a ear wipe, or you can go with this epiotic ear cleaner. Okay, and then the nail clipper.
Okay.
And for
so where would you get all of these products?
You will get on Amazon. You can get on their website also, the Oxford website. Anywhere you can get.
Okay, cool. So guys, you can get all of these products on Amazon. You can get it at your local pet shop. You can get it at your local medical shop, you know, maybe a veterinary medical shop, at your vet, and at, you know, these awesome websites like Dogspot.
These are very much easily available products, actually.
Yeah, cool. So, I mean, so now you guys have no excuse to not brush your cats and make sure they're tangle-free at home. All right, cool. So, Shri is asking, how safe is it to clip your cat's nails? I believe it is for their safety.
Okay, so nail clipping, if you have an indoor cat, and you just have to clip, like, you know, just a tip of the nails. I really don't recommend clipping the nails every time. If you see it's too much grown, then, like, you know, you can trim it, because it's kind of a defense weapon for them. If in case they might, like, you know, run out, like, you know, escape or something, so they don't have anything to defend themselves. So they need their claws, they need their nails to, like, you know, save themselves.
Okay.
So you can just cut the tip of the nails, that's it.
Okay, so basically don't cut the nail too far back. Just cut like the little, the pointy bit that is. And with cat's nails, guys, I've seen that it's pretty easy actually to cut their nails, because you can actually see the vein really, really clearly. You know, there aren't many cats that have a black nail, you know, like in dogs, and it gets really scary to cut their nails. So cats, it's a little bit easier in terms of seeing. Maybe not in terms of actually holding them and cutting their nail, because then they might just, you know.
No, so holding also, it totally depends. You don't have to, like, you know, you don't need 3-4 people to hold a cat. See, my cat is comfortable because I'm not really, like, I'm just holding. If 2-3 people come and control, they will try to restrain and they will try to run off. So just give them space.
So they're going to rebel.
Just give them space.
Okay, so go in with a positive attitude and you know, go in with a very calm demeanor, and I think that's the best way to start grooming your cat. Okay,
or
okay,
any
we
pet.
Have a question. That is true, actually, for any pet. Okay, so we have a question from Kaveri. She says, "Hi, Menas. Most Indian cats don't take well to baths. What would be a good way to positively get them to start liking it and making it a part of their grooming activity, particularly kittens and also adults who are adopted? Thanks."
Okay, so Kaveri, what you can do is you can start, don't use the shampoo immediately. You can start by pouring, like, you know, take a cloth which is, like, you know, very much like, you know, a wet cloth. Try wiping so that they will get the feeling, okay, now this is a water, this is nothing else, okay. Then what you can do is bathe your cat in a kitchen sink. Don't bathe your cat in, like, you know, in a surface which is, like, very much slippery. So they try to, like, you know, they need something, a grip kind of thing. Or you can place some towel or something so that your cat will be very much comfortable. Just for initially, start with water, okay, and wipe with like, you know, towel. Then the second, once your cat is comfortable, then you can start using, like, you know, shampoos. Then you can, the other stages, you can start using hair dryer and all that stuff. So it takes, like, you know, level to, like, you know, go into that level where your cat is very much comfortable.
So you would say that Kaveri is a groomer. So you would say that if she gets a new indie cat that's, you know, coming to her for grooming, you know, she should go slow and introduce the cat to the grooming process one step at a time in case it's getting too freaked out. Okay, cool. Achis is asking, can we use medicated shampoo once in a week on cats?
Why you want to use medicated shampoo? You know, if the doctor is prescribing a medicated shampoo, that means, like, you know, you have to ask the doctor for what purpose. Like, you know, if your cat is having any kind of fungal or bacterial infection, then use medicated shampoo. If your cat is very much fit, fine, you don't have to use medicated shampoo. It's like when we have fever or something like that, we take the tablet that time. We don't take the tablet any random time, okay? Just, like, you know, okay, today is my mood, okay, to take a tablet, I'll just go ahead and I take a tablet. No. When you have fever or something like that, that time only you will take a medicated stuff.
Cool. Okay, so Batul is asking, do we have to dilute all types of shampoo before grooming, or directly can we use them?
No, we have to dilute shampoos, and we have to dilute the conditioner also when you use on any pet. Though it is dog, cat, you have to dilute the shampoo.
Okay, and would you say that, you know, what kind of temperature should the water be at? You know, is it okay to give them a bath with cold water, like regular tap water? Does it need to be extra warm? Does it need to be lukewarm? So if somebody's going to bathe their cat at home,
it should be extra
warm. It should be a little bit warmer.
Warm. Yeah.
Not too hot.
Yeah, not too hot.
So
not
basically,
yeah.
Okay. So, like, you know, the way they test baby bottles, right? You put it on this part of your hand, you know, and see whether it's burning you or not. And is that how you would check water as well?
Yeah. Is it, like, you know, wearable and all? Yeah.
Okay, cool. Okay, so moving on, Menas has shown us how to brush a cat. What is the next thing that you would like to show us, Menas?
The eye cleaning.
Okay, cool.
So shall we start with the eye cleaning?
Yeah, we can do eye cleaning. So guys, you know, just keep your eyes peeled here. Menaz is going to show you how to clean your cat's eyes. Most long-haired cats do, you know, actually most pug-nosed cats get this little tear stains, you know, near their eyes. And you want to be able to keep, you know, keep that clean so that they're not getting any fungal infections and things. So please, whenever you're next to the eyes, be very, very careful. And now Menaz is going to just demonstrate on how you should be doing it. Please watch carefully. And if you are not confident, I would not recommend you do anything like this.
Yeah. And to clean the eyes, you can just take a normal water, or you can take a saline solution that is you get at the medical store, that is NS. Okay, that you can take, or you get this kind of solutions, which is I don't think so it's available in Indian market, but I really love this product. Yeah, King Popal.
Okay,
it's kind of a solution to really clean the face area and the eye area, which is really a good
solution. So is it a tear-free thing?
Yeah, it's tear-free and it's tearless and very nice solution to clean, actually, to remove all the mud, dust, whatever it is near the eye.
Okay. So in case, since you're saying this is a product that is not available in India, in case, we are not able to get something like this, you suggest that we use saline solution or just clean water. Warm water or something with some cotton,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, okay, that's it. Cool. That's it. Okay. So, okay. So you have to use one cotton swab on one eye. Don't mix the cotton swab for this eye, that eye, because in case if there is any kind of bacterial infection or something, you're not passing to another eye. It will just stay near the one eye. Okay. So take another cotton swab. Okay. Gently, don't force your cat. Never force your cat, or if your cat is trying to run, no problem. Let the cat run away. Catch the cat again. Depends on their mood also.
So basically what you seem to be doing is you're just gently removing the the dirt away from the eye, right?
Yeah. So yeah, that's what I'm doing. That's it. And then take a normal cotton swab. Whatever
the plain, dry cotton swab.
Yeah. Whatever extra is there, just remove it off.
Okay. Okay. So they look cleaner. Yeah. Mm. So this is something that we should do. That a cat owner should be doing. How often at home?
Every day.
Every day, right? Okay. Cool. And this would be especially for cats that have a slightly flatter nose, flatter face.
Yeah. Mostly punch face, exotics and all this.
Okay. So I've seen in these punch-faced cats, next to the nose area also, they have this little buildup.
Yeah.
So would you recommend that you clean it with that, with the same solution?
With the same solution, and make sure if you use any kind of products on the face, it should be tearless products, because what you're doing is when you are bathing a punch face cat, so they tend to have the duct wherein the normal shampoo irritates their duct. So you have to use a tearless shampoos always near the face area, and make sure to wash this area, because they tend to get more of the acne. This area, the acne problem. If you see this area, the acne problem. So whenever you try to wash the face, use toothbrush of kids, right? Just to
soft bristle toothbrush.
Yeah, just to remove that acne or something like that, and then wash it. Okay. Don't pour the water directly on the face. Gently, just take in your hands and wash it off.
And when you're bathing at home, what about getting water in the ears? What would you do to prevent that?
So you can use a cotton swab inside the ears and keep it, and then you can wash your cats. And if you're using if you're washing your the cat's face, use your hand and try to gently just instead of pouring the water, just with the hand gently just rub it, whatever the water, shampoo and all, it will just come off.
Okay, cool. So we had Amrish has been asking us a question, but Amrish, we don't really understand your question. So if you could please ask us, it more clear, because it says over here, what can I give for cats and how much does it cost? So I don't really understand what you're asking about. So if you could just, re-ask us your question and okay, so Alexander is asking, how often can we groom and bathe the cats?
So if you have a house pet cat, I would recommend once in 5 weeks, once in 45 days or something, both for long hair and as well as for the short hair, or once in 2 months or something. That's it.
Okay, so tell me something, Mena. There is this is a little thing, a question that I have actually. I have had clients in my salon, whose cats are pretty naughty, and they've gone into the kitchen and they've dropped some oil on themselves. So what would you, how would you get that oil off the cat?
Okay, so
kitchen oil, like cooking oil.
Cooking oil. Okay, so what you have to do is, first you get this Johnson's baby powder, which is a cornstarch, okay. Or you can use a cornstarch, pure cornstarch, which we use in our kitchen daily use, right? So just sprinkle that cornstarch. That cornstarch absorb all the grease, whatever it is. Then you use a degreasing shampoo. If you don't have a degreasing shampoo, that is Ketoclore, one medicated shampoo is there. Okay. So you can go ahead with that Ketoclore shampoo, wash it off, and then you have to use another, the normal shampoo. So it's like a long procedure.
Okay, right. So in case that happens, guys at home, please take your cat to a groomer. I think they'll,
it will not go in one wash or something. You might need two washes. Your cat might need two washes.
Okay, cool. So Batul is asking, can we use eye wipes to clean the eyes, or do we need to use cotton? And so kind of eye wipes would you recommend? Can we use regular baby wipes, or do they have to be specialized wipes?
Specialized eye wipes. So near this eye area, I recommend whatever it is, eye product, only use that. Don't use any other kind, because this is this very sensitive part of cats. Okay.
Okay.
So you don't want to take any kind of risk. So you get this Petkin eye wipe, which is really good. So you can use that. Okay. You get the Petkin ear wipes also, which is really a good product. You can go ahead and use that.
Okay. And these would be available on Dogspot or on Amazon.
Amazon.
Or anywhere, from your local pet shops.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Great. Cool. Okay, so now, we've spoken about the eyes. Now, how about we move on to the ears? Because, many cat owners kind of ignore the ears and they don't notice how dirty and gunky the ears have become, over some time. So if you could just tell us, how do we keep your cat's ears clean? And what are the, problems that can arise if you don't keep your cat's ears clean?
Okay, so if you see when you get a cat, when you adopt a cat, first thing you have to see is the cat ears. Basically, if you see the cat ears, it shouldn't have a black color dirt or something. That indicates most of the cats generally they have ear mites. They come with that only, most of the cats. So what you have to do is you have to be very much careful. If you see any kind of black things which is coming out from the ears, take your cat to the vet and let the cat vet clean the ears. If not, if you see the cat ears is now it is very much clean, just go ahead, take a cotton, cotton swab or something. Then your normal ear cleaning solution, which is cat safe, not the tea tree one and all that thing. You don't have to use all that chemicals on your cats.
Okay. So basically all products that we use it should be written that it's safe for cats, right?
Yes. And just gently just clean it, whatever it is. That's it. That's not going in too deep inside.
We can't really see it, Menas. Can you just show it to us a little bit better? We can't really see it in the camera. Yeah.
Is it visible now?
Yes.
One minute. Don't pour the solution inside your cat's ear, because they don't like it. Never do that.
But what if the ears are really, really dirty then?
Then you have to take your cat to the vet, because they have to clean it from inside.
Okay.
Okay. So,
okay. Just okay. So basically clean it more from the top and don't go too deep inside, right?
Yes.
Would
yes.
you recommend that you use earbuds to clean the cat's ears?
No. You might damage the eardrums and everything. You don't have to.
Okay, cool. So it turns out that Amrish is a little upset with us. He was asking what kind of food he should give his, the best food to give his cat.
And so I think Amrish, foods available.
Correct. The better person to ask would be a nutritionist or a vet. Menaz is a groomer, so she's going to be helping us with more grooming related things rather than, nutrition. Okay.
Right.
So Sheba is asking, teeth. How to clean the teeth? My cat is a biter in general, and I need a safe method. What would you say, Menaz?
Okay. So I don't recommend using any kind of teeth wipe or something for cats. It's like, as I told you earlier also, sheer ke muh mein haath nahi dalna hai hame. What you have to do is, you get the liquid solutions, okay? Just pour in the water, okay? And that, let them drink. And like once a year or something like that, you can get the dental scaling done. If after 4-5 years, when you see the tata build up or something like that, once a year, you can just go to your vet and get that thing done. That's the only solution I can give.
Okay. Sheba, also, if you on DogSpot, we had done a session on dental hygiene for pets. There's a product called Plaqoff. The lady from that company had actually joined us, and it was a very informative session. So maybe you could go back and check out the session, and there are some really cool tips and tricks on how to keep your pets clean. Okay, so Batul is asking. Some people use ivermectin to clean the ear at home. Is it safe?
Ivermectin, no. It's a vet call. You can't really take the decision of ivermectin or any kind of medication. Self-medication is a big no-no for cats.
Okay. Okay. Achis is asking, need more about matted hair. Could you give us a little more information on how mats probably occur and how do we avoid them What are our red flags and all of those kind of things?
So basically, mats, if you see, it develops when you don't bathe your cat. It's due to the greasiness on the coat. Okay. That is the reason mats form. So what you have to do is you have to remove it by bathing your cat, regularly brushing your cat, combing your cat. That is the only way, you can
avoid
the mats and all. Yeah.
Okay. So looks like Smurf has had enough now of the section and wants to go and take a little chakkar. Okay. So Suhas is asking, we're back to the ears. Any tips on how to clean ears of those cats who don't cooperate?
Just use a wipe. Okay. Just place your cat like that and try to clean it off. Smoky ko dena na main bata di usko. So just try to wipe it off Don't really, you don't have to open the ear flap and do it. Start with slowly, and then your cat will get used to it.
Okay, so basically make it like a playful session and make it like a calm, loving session that you're scratching them.
And your cat will be with you, so you don't have to worry at one go only you have to do everything. You don't have to do everything. You have to just calmly get the cat used
to. So could you demonstrate to us how you would hold your cat to clean the ears? Maybe a naughty cat who's doesn't really like being hugged or cuddled, and how would you handle a cat like that and clean the ears?
Yeah, so what you can do is just take a wipe. Just take wipe and gently kindly just massage. That's it.
Okay. Right. So basically pretend like you're playing with them and you're scratching their ears and just
massaging. That's it.
Okay. Cool. All right. So Kaveri has a question again. She says, best way to keep the cat calm while drying at home, please. Also, would you recommend any calming products for cats while grooming, especially the ones who are super scared, alarmed, non-cooperative?
Best way to calm your cat while drying. Okay. So you get this happy hoodie. on this thing, online websites, or Amazon also is having it. What you can do is, what I do with aggressive cat is I put the cotton birds, cotton inside the ear, then I put the happy hoodie so that the ear, the hair dryer noise doesn't, like, you know, irritate them. And what I do is I take someone's help and try tell them to, like, you know, blow dry the cat from far away, not too close to the cat. Okay, so okay. Smokey, he doesn't like drying at all, though he's, like, you know, my cat, but he doesn't like. So what I do is, my sister and me, I sit with my cat, I cuddle, I give him treats and all, and she will be drying him from far. So that is okay. The only way. And you get this kind of, like, you know, catnip sprays, which is available. So you can just place the catnip okay. spray, just spray it around so that the cat will be calm. Yeah, but sometimes it gives the ulta effect wherein, like, you know, your cat might get very hyper.
Overexcited. And
yes.
Right. So would you recommend things like, you know, like these aromatherapy oils or, you know, these diffusers or anything like that to keep your cat?
No, it's toxic.
It's not. So regardless of which. Okay, so you should avoid it at all costs. And
yeah, you get this Ferryville diffuser, which is really good, actually, which helps in calming the cat.
Can you say that again? We didn't get that.
Ferryville. F-E-L-I-W-A-Y.
Ferryway. Is that available in India?
On Amazon, yes, it is available.
Okay, it's available on Amazon. Okay, mm-hmm. Cool. Okay, so Saloni is asking us, what are some other common cat grooming myths? So we had touched upon, what gives allergies and whether the cats actually clean themselves or not. So is there anything else, like a common myth that, or maybe you could just elaborate on those ones?
So basically, I think so that is the only myth wherein, like, you know, people have, like, okay, my cat is not really okay with Smokey. One second, sit ma. Am I here? Yeah. So people say my cats don't require grooming. We touched that topic wherein, like, you know, my cats don't need grooming. And these are the people, once, like, you know, when the cat is, like, around 4-5 years old, then they will come suddenly to a groomer saying, okay, now right. we need a grooming because it's fully matted, knotted and all. So right. it's really difficult that time for us to cooperate with the cats.
Right. Okay. Because the cat is not used to the process and they would get really, really stressed out and, you know, scared exactly. and be wondering, what are you doing suddenly to me? Okay. So Achis is asking, after a bath, which is the best to dry hair? Hot air or cool air? After that, stand in sunlight for 10 minutes is also good. He's asking, which is the best way to dry your hair, dry the cat's hair after the bath?
So you have to use not too hot, not too cold, a medium, you have to set the dryer on a medium, this thing, and dry. Sunlight for 10 minutes, sunlight every day is really good for them. Okay, you don't have to really, like, you know, use the sunlight to dry, because if you don't dry your cat's hair, their skin might get more of the infection and all.
Okay, so you mean, like, it could lead to fungal infections or fungal, those kind of things because of the damage?
Yeah, because of the damage.
Okay, cool. So, you know, I have seen very often that Indian cats give us most trouble when it comes to, grooming. They don't really like the whole process. They don't like being, held down. They don't like their ears clean, nails cut, bath, this, that. So, if at all somebody has adopted a stray, maybe from the street or, you know, or they've adopted from an adoption center, how would you suggest and how soon would you suggest that you introduce that kitten to bathing? And what process would you follow if the kitten is really scared and stuff like that? How would you do that?
So I will go ahead with slow process, wherein first I'll try, like, you know, just gently combing. You get the Zoom Broom brush, like, you know, for the cats. What you can do is gently start with the massage thing and all. So gently start with cleaning the ears, then little bit of nail clipping, then, like, you know, trying to wipe your cat, okay? Then start introducing your cat with, like, you know, with a hairdryer also. You don't have to use the hairdryer on the cat. What you can do is just place it at one corner so that the cat used to get the sound.
Right,
of the,
like, ambient sound.
Yeah. So she will be used to it. Okay, now, like, you know, this sound is not really, like, you know, a threat for me. So yeah, that way, like, you know, at least every day, five minutes or something, just place it at one corner. Yeah.
Okay. So do you get them used to the process? You get them used to the sound rather than
at
just
a very early,
you know, suddenly. All right. Yeah. So that will solve your you know, your problem for the rest of your life, you know, to groom your cat and to dry your cat, because sometimes during the rainy season you can't really get your cats out into the sun because there isn't any sun, and you might need to use a hair dryer. So it's better to introduce your kitten to a dryer earlier
at a very early age.
Yeah, so that they are okay with that. Okay. Okay. Shabir is asking, can you suggest some products to enhance a cat's fur growth?
That you have to ask the doctor, because there are many supplements which are available in the market which I can't really help you with. Yeah, but yeah, if you groom your cat regularly with proper drying and all that thing, it will really help in, like, you know, blood circulation. In that way, you are, like, you know, helping in the fur growth. But yeah, internally, for the supplements, for the food, you better ask your vets.
Okay, cool. So Batul has a question. Okay, there it is. Thoughts about sedation before grooming? Do you think it's safe to sedate a cat and then groom it, or do you think it's worse to actually let a cat completely freak out when it's being groomed? Which is, if you were to choose between a cat that really does not like grooming, would you choose to sedate that cat and then groom it quickly, or would you let it be, you know, let it get stressed out and, like, try and quickly finish the grooming? How would you approach this subject?
If you know the process, your process, like, you know, how to handle the cat and all, the cat will not go under any kind of stress or trauma if you know how to handle the cat. Okay, so I don't think so. Grooming, like, you know, if you see, when I hold the cat or something, the cat doesn't go into stress and all, because I know, you have to know, like, you know, how exactly to hold the cat. You can't just pull one corner, or you can't just, like, you know, grab your cat, like, you know, just, like, you know, from the mane or something. It's not really recommended.
Okay, so you know, I have seen. Sorry to interrupt. I have seen many vets. You know, not vets, but I've seen a few groomers. You know, they, like, hold the cat and they hold the front legs and the back legs, and they'll stretch the cat out and they'll quickly try and groom it. Do you think that is a recommended method to actually deal with cats?
Not really. So imagine, like, you know, if you're going to a salon, suddenly, like, you know, and if you really like a kind of a nice massage, you won't, like, you know, that da-da-da-da-da massage. You need a relaxation. That should be a relaxation session for you, not like a kind of a trauma session or something like that.
Right. So would you say that your energy and your, you know, your composition, like how you compose yourself, makes a lot of difference on the cat?
Yeah. Yes, definitely. Okay. They take our vibes a lot. So we have to be, like, you know, very much calm. If, like, you know, I would suggest all the pet parents, whoever, like, you know, are there watching, please be calm while giving your cat a bath. Don't panic. It's just a cat groom, nothing else. Like, you know, it's not a kind of a mission or something. Just calm yourself. Go with the flow. If your cat is not okay, start with the water. Then go ahead with the shampoo and all that thing. You have a couple of, like, you know, you don't have to get into all these things at once. Only one process, it's really good for them.
So what I gather from what you say is that with cats, it has to be really slow and easy, and you don't have to do, you know, anything too quickly and too suddenly and get too aggressive with them. They don't like it, right?
If at all
a person has to choose a groomer for their cat, you know, what would you say? What would you say are the good things about a good groomer for a cat? And what would you say would be red flags that, you know, okay, be careful, your cat might not be okay?
So what happens, you know, mostly, like, I allow parents to watch the grooming whenever they are inside, okay? But sometimes few pet parents are like, my cat will be okay, my cat will not get stressed out. That so what happens, you know, that pet parents' energy cats get. So it's very difficult for us to work with the cat. So what I do is I tell them, okay, can you just sit outside? You can watch whatever the process is happening from the CCTV. I give them, like, you know, the visibility. See, we are not really harming your cat. Your cat is really in, like, you know, safe hands. And the way, like, you know, you should see your the cat should be very much comfortable. The cat shouldn't freak out. The cat shouldn't try to escape from the groomer's hand. And, like, you know, the holding techniques also. So the cat should be very much comfortable. If they are comfortable, I think so, like, you know, the pet parents can trust the groomer.
Okay. So Kaveri has a question regarding how you should handle. She said, would you please demonstrate the best way to hold a cat while grooming?
While grooming, okay, you don't have to hold too much to the cat, okay? So if Kaveri, I want to bathe a cat, right? So what I'll do is I will always face the cat's face on the tub side, not towards me, because if the cat is towards me, they will try to come up on me. They will try to jump or escape from here. So if, like, you know, right. I want to bathe a cat, right? So what I'll do is they will not have any kind of escape kind of thing. Okay, now it's like, you know, the tub is in front. They will not really run. So I'll start pouring the water gently and I'll start giving them a bath and all. So this is one way. And, like, you know, if you want to really rub, wash the underbelly or something, just hold the cat gently, okay? And then you can just rub it.
Okay. Oh, free cuddles, free life session cuddles, those are.
Yeah. Okay. So you can just hold like this. You can just, like, you know, rub the underbelly and all that thing. You don't have to hold too much to the cat. The more you hold, the more they will try to run from you.
Okay, cool. All right, and what about, you know, if you have to, like, probably shave off some, you know, mats from in the tummy or something like that, then how would you hold the cat? Would you be able to do it alone or would you need help?
We need a help. Yes, we need a help because we will be using a blade or something. We don't want to nick the cat's skin. So we need a help to stretch the skin. And whenever you want, like, you know, whenever you are trying to trim the knots or something, it's always better to stretch the skin and do it. It will make your work really easy.
Okay. All right. Cool. Okay. So let me see. Do we have any other questions? Yes. Yeah, Saloni says, Smokey looks so cuddly. Yes, Saloni is very cuddly. All right. So moving on now, the next thing that we wanted to cover was trimming your cat's nails, which is what a lot of people had been asking us about. So if Minaj, if you could just demonstrate on how you should trim a cat's nails and, you know, what are the, how to be careful and, you know, what are things that can go wrong and go right and blah and blah and blah. So, yeah.
Okay. So you want me to do it with a normal nail clipper, which we have at home, or you want me to do it with a pet nail clipper?
A pet nail clipper, I think, will be better.
Yeah. Okay, Smokey, nail clipping time. So again, hold your cat from backward. Okay. Lift, I think so now. Okay. Lift one paw. Okay. Gently press the paw pad of the cat and trim it off. Just the tip. That's it. That's it. Okay. You just have to press the paw pad of the cat. That's it. The nails will automatically come out. I don't think so. It's visible.
Yeah, it's not very very easily visible.
One second. I can just show it on my mobile torch. No, it's not visible, I guess.
Yeah, that's a little bit better though. Yeah.
So, just, like, you know, remove the nail. Okay. It's okay, Smokey. Who's there? Who's there? Someone is coming. Okay, okay.
Okay. Smokey knows. He's being used as a little guinea pig now. Hi, Smokey.
Just gently press the below paw pad, okay, of the cat and trim the nails. That's it. Okay?
Okay. It's so very just the tip of the nail, right?
Just the tip of the nails. You don't have to hurt your cat. That's it. Okay? Just lift one paw and that's it. Done.
Okay.
Done?
So using basically what I can see you are doing is you've got your body sort of over your cat. And you're leaning over without actually putting your weight there, but you're able to restrict the movement, and get the work done without actually stressing the cat out and without holding it down too hard, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So Saloni is asking if we can get a short-haired cat for this, if you have anybody that you can, do you have somebody that you can demonstrate on, a short-haired cat?
Yeah, but she doesn't sit, that's the problem. One second.
Okay. No, that's okay. So don't, no need to stress. That's okay.
Let me just show if it's, then it's okay. Wo Bengal dena na.
Batul is saying he is one of the examples of a cat who doesn't like grooming.
Yeah, Smokey doesn't like too much of blow drying and on. So we have to be okay. Very much slow. It takes somewhere around 2 hours for me and Batul to groom Smokey. We both need each other's help while grooming Smokey.
Okay, yeah. So Alexander has a question. Is there any special towel to be used for cats after a bath?
No. So what you have to do is like just a normal towel. Okay. Open the towel and wrap your cat like a burrito. Okay. Normally. You don't have to like just wipe the cat and leave. No. Just wrap so that it absorbs all the water. And then you can start with the drying process and all. Yeah. For the short hair, I don't recommend drying the cat immediately. The cat should get used to it with the drying process. And all. I know.
What?
I know.
Okay, so basically regular towels are good enough to use for your cats. You don't really need anything special. Okay, yeah. So better to just wrap your cat around like a chapati roll and, you know, like a kebab and chapati roll and and eat them up.
Too much of
this. Hi, Vinayak, how are you? Cool. So we're gonna be demonstrating. Hopefully, gonna try and demonstrate on this little cutie.
Yeah.
On how we can cut his nails.
Oh, the nail clipping? Yes. I know what. I know. Okay. I think so. Now is it visible? Nails?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Her nails are already trimmed.
Oh, her nails are already trimmed. Oh, okay.
I know. Okay, she's like, really? Her nails are already trimmed. If you want, I can show the just like, you know, kind of a just using a Furminator on her, how to use a Furminator.
Yeah. Okay, so it seems to be like it's at a 90 degree angle to the skin.
Yeah, that's it. I know. You can hear her meow like anything.
Ethan wants to photobomb a cat session.
Hi, Nico. Hi. Just ate her food. She's just like. I think so. She just ate her food.
Oh, okay.
No, you're Miko.
Okay, Miko. No. She didn't eat her food. She just came because she wanted some of the action. Hey, Babu, you want to go down now?
You want a cat, Miko? Miko, you have one cat. No, kitty. Where's your kitty?
Oh, my one is actually sprawled out underneath my table here. She's showing me all of her fluffy bits. Okay, cool. So, guys, do we have any other questions for Menaz that you guys would like to ask? Anything that didn't, you know, that we have not touched upon and you want us to answer for you? Please type in your questions here in the comments and we will try and answer as many as possible.
I'm fully with the cat here.
Yeah. So, Saloni had asked a question earlier. She said, are there any cat grooming certification courses for people who want to learn more? So, is there something available?
Register with us, PPGIA, so that we can like, you know, help you out with more of the courses for cat grooming, dog grooming and everything.
Right. So so Menaz is actually on the PPGIA board and she's in charge of, you know, she's head of our cat grooming section. And if at all any of you are interested in learning cat grooming, you know, Menaz has, you know, a training program ready. So you guys can contact her directly. Yeah, and you know, she's the best person to learn from over here in India, at least I think. And she's really dedicated her life so to cats. And I think, how many cats do you have at home, Menaz?
10 cats.
So she's the crazy cat lady. All of her 10 kitties, and so you know that you know she knows what she's doing. So guys, again, I'm going to ask you, if there are any more questions, please ask us now, and otherwise we'll be wrapping up. And we're really happy to have all of you guys here, and thank you so much for joining us for today's session. And we hope we were able to help a lot of you. If you have any more questions, you can contact us directly. You can contact Menaz at the Catspert. And Menaz, if you can just tell us the exact handle for, you know, for the guys to follow you, ask questions and stuff?
Yeah, the cat spurts. You can ask the question related to cat grooming, cat behavior also. We really like, you know, take care of. If your cat is having any kind of behavioral issues also, we do take care. Grooming related, any questions, you can just like, you know, message us on the cat spurts.
Okay. Also, Batul has like put in this very good question. It's about scatting. If you could quickly, you know, just go down that the thing, explain that to us and how to take care of that.
So scat tail basically happens to most of the intact males, like, you know, male cats. So you will see they have the oil secretion on the tail. What you have to do is for the scat tail, you have to use a cornstarch, sprinkle little cornstarch because it absorbs all the greasiness. And then you can.
So, would you do this before the bath, or you would do it before the bath? You mean?
Yeah, cornstarch. Yeah, before the bath, at least like, you know, 15-20 minutes prior to the bath. Don't make your cat lick. If they lick, is also that's not a problem, but we should just avoid it. Okay, and then like, you know, 10-15 minutes, just like, you know, let it settle. Normally, then with a normal shampoo which you use on your cat, just wash it off. And this has to be done every week. Only on the tail part, and make sure you dry the cat tail very
nice. So basically every week you would just wash and like just do the cornstarch and wash out just the tail area. You do not need to bathe your entire cat just to
and if take your cat is having scat tail, definitely they might have a chin acne also. There also you can just place a little bit of like, you know, cornstarch and like, you know, just wash it off that area. Make sure you dry the area very well.
Okay. So if we leave it, suppose we leave it damp, then is there any, you know, what are the consequences?
Then you will, then they will get bacterial and fungal infection over there because of the acne.
Okay. All right. Cool. Cool. So, Nikita is a late bloomer and she's just come into our session. Nikita, we've actually answered this question earlier, but I'm sure Menoz won't mind, you know, doing a quick recap on do you suggest shaving cats down?
No, I don't really recommend shaving cats down. As I said, their follicle is very much like, you know, smaller. And if you shave the cat, basically you are harming the cat. You're not really doing any kind of good to them. You're just like, you know, harming your cat. What you can do is if you want to maintain your cat, you are not able to like, you know, maintain the coat or something like that. Just 1 inch of like, you know, trimming you can do entire on the entire body. Yeah, trimming sometimes it really looks like, you know, the comb cut and all. It doesn't look good on the cat. But yeah, just for like, you know, maintenance purpose, you can go ahead and do that.
Okay, awesome. Cool. Okay, we seem to be having more. Okay, so Batul is asking how to remove stains from the paw area.
Stains, see, I don't think so. The products which, like, you know, I use for staining purpose are available in India. What you can do is you can just wash and dry the area. Normally, the paw area, what happens is on the paw area, they get the staining because when they rub their eyes like this. So if you clean your cat's eyes regularly, then the paw area will not get, like, you know, stained out.
Okay, all right. So basically, you really want, of your,
if you really want, like, you know, if you can afford to buy a good product, like, you know, a kind of a stain removing powder or something like that, you can go ahead with this Breeder Care product. Breeder Care, this thing, powder.
I can't really see it. It's called Breeder Care, is it?
Yeah, Breeder Care, or you get this Pink Pawpaw powder, which is really good. You get all these things in Thailand, okay? This one. Okay. Then there is one more which is coming in India, which is Green Made. It will
so
be
guys,
available.
If you have, if you need to know more about these products and how they are used, you know, you guys can get in touch with Batul and with Menaz and Batul. They would be able to help you, you know, answer these questions for you. For now, we are, you know, gonna say bye bye, and we hope you enjoyed the session. And we're sorry, you know, to everybody who didn't get their questions answered. I think there was one person that was upset because it wasn't really relevant to us.
Yeah,
but
so
I think I've learned a lot during this session, and I hope you guys have too. And I just want to say thank you so much for joining us, and thank you, Menaz, for taking the time and, you know, sharing your knowledge with us. So now we'll just say bye-bye now, and you guys have a great weekend and a great evening. See you.
Yeah.
Bye-bye, everybody.
Stay safe. Bye.
Bye. Okay.